cold.
This is the point which I would like to add to you.
They feel what in marriage life?
Sacred, the kedusha, the holiness of marriage life. And I will tell you something. If the mitzvah of marriage life is a davak b'ishto, husband and wife should get glued to each other, to be one.
Yeah, but today is different. Are you talking about them or are you talking about our life?
Talking about all of us.
Today is, from what I see from outside, in order to be happy, you have to make your mother-in-law happy, you have to make your father-in-law happy, brother-in-law happy. Then the question arises, you get married to him, to her, or to them?
I'll answer with the Midrash. One of the brachot in your wedding that they did, if you remember many years ago, I said the sixth bracha is, Hashem would make you sameach like Adam and Eve. So one rabbi told me, how do you know they were happy? They said, no father, no mother, no. How can be upset? Nobody to bother them. So this is according... Yeah, but this is not my question. The question is, it is another mistake that we are doing. We try to separate the package deal from the deal itself. It means, when you got married to your wife, and then you get the package deal. Father and mother.
Yeah, but we're not talking about anybody specific
cousins,
over here.
33rd cousins, 5 in-laws, and everybody become yours now. Now, if you try to separate it, it's very difficult. But again, it is how strong you are. But this marriage life is all about the Kedushan marriage life. And I will make another point, not to get a different point. I think it's more important. How can you check your Yirat Shamayim? Listen carefully. How can you check your Yirat Shamayim today? If you feel, as a religious couple, if you want, the man wants to be close emotionally, physically to his wife, and not running away, it's mean he's spiritual, he's holy, and if she wants to be close to her husband, why? Because then they understand that the love of Hashem and the love of the spouse and the love of yourself is one thing. So if somebody tells me, you know, I want to run away, I need a vacation, I need a vacation, there's no problem with the spouse, there's a problem with the Yirat Shamayim. They don't love Hashem because they don't love themselves. Because you cannot tell me, because my right hand hurts, my left, I'm going to hit my right hand, then it's going to be okay.
And they need another vacation after this vacation. Because they have no idea what they're looking for, that physical pleasure.
And again, we're not against physical pleasure too, it's a part of the Torah. But again, what you are seeking for? Are you seeking to get connected?
Yeah, but those people are lost. If a person is looking for physical...
Talking about religious people.
You know, I took once my wife to Jones Beach, let's say, for example. I said, if I'm going to put you to sleep for 2 days, and I'm going to wake you up over here, can you tell where you are? She said, I don't know. I said, if I'll tell you in Spain, can you believe me? She said, probably yes. So basically what happens is, they're looking for this process, go to the airport, fly in, and basically they come to the same beach as they have over here. And that's it. That's what they...
You're too mechanical.
What do you mean mechanical? Because people trying to look for something that they have
over here. Let's say you like plov. I can tell you, I'll give you 2 pounds of fries, 3 markovka, 2 onions, and a piece of... eat them separately, then enjoy it.
Yeah, but you see, like you don't like plov, you like your stomach.
No, we need it. We need the entire thing. You're wrong about it.
Why?
Because it's part of the idea.
Which idea? When you eat...
With husband and wife, I told you, you're going to the other thing. The Gemara says in Masechet Kiddushin, there is a boy that gives to his father every day 2 sikh of shashlik, as kibud avayim and goes to Gehinnom, lo aleinu. And there is a boy who lets his father to walk with him and to carry heavy weights, and he goes to Gan Eden. Omer HaTosfot, how it's possible? He gives to his father the food, says his father, don't talk to him today. He gives him the food, but in a way of what, Roma?
Disrespect.
So basically, it's not what you do, it's how you do it.
And then he said to his father, I'm very busy, and then his father, I'm going to help you. So you understand, Roma? If there is 2 ways to come over here. There is a way I come to do it, there is to do it with the respectful way. Yeah, but, way.
You know, I'm not a specialist, but I never saw any rabbi eating shish kebab or all that stuff. Because you don't live to eat, you eat to live. According to what you're saying, people live to eat. Because shish kebab is an example, which normal rabbi would eat shish kebab? Show me one rabbi that celebrates birthday, that does eat shish kebab, that even looking for... I'm not talking about I'm saying in general.
Talking about Rabbi in your area, I don't know, maybe they fasting all day, Baruch Hashem, God bless them. So no, people eat shishli kebab, but it's not the issue. The issue how to eat it. How to do it.
After 4 months of shagging on the Psachim, we had a nice Simchat Torah, and we enjoyed. But we shagged for 4 months.
Yeah, but you were eating not because of the disease states. You're eating because you make Hashem happy, and you're happy with Simchat Torah. It's like a wedding. This is what you are doing. Not just find them to. So I believe that if somebody would like to displeasure what they have, they will cannot have a marriage, a normal marriage life, because if it's based on desires, people need changing. They need this food, this thing. They become so involved in this world that they are losing the essence of life. When we talk in Judaism, we're talking about the good things. And I told you once the story, and after I gave the story, a few of you called me, Sarah, you sure it's not a good example. I'll give you this example again, and I'll tell you the real story what happened. There was a student in my yeshiva in Bnei Brak that used to be very... He has a certain disorder, OCD. Everything had to be
perfect,
in order. If it's like this, it's the end of the world. So he got married to a nice woman, nice girl, very nice. Everything is okay, but she was not OCD like him. She's making the house clean. But every time he comes, he finds something. And he said, I cannot live with you. It's too much, you know. The shoes are not here, and this is here. And if it's not like this, if it's not straight, if it has to be in an angle, not a real case. So I went to, we come to our Rosh Hashiva. I told the Rosh Hashiva, what should I do? So he said, come to my house in the noontime. He called his wife and say, make the house mess. And so she messed the house. So we sit and eat now the lunch. So there over here, there is linen over here, laundry over here, shoes on the floor, there is Shabbat clothing, the Saturday shult is still on there, it's on the, like a nice house, you know. And he's calling and he's coming inside the house and he sees the mess, and the Rosh Hashiva is eating. He say, what's your problem? He say, are you living in this... In this environment? I said, what's wrong? I said, what's wrong? He said, I think I live in heaven, he told him, and he left. So I gave him the shoe. After the shoe, the husband called me and said, Rabbi Yeshua, our wife is not clean, and now you gave her permission. Now we are become the victims. Why did you tell it to them? The story of the Rosh Hashiva was to give him an idea that everything is a matter of your
perception.
Yes, clean, not clean, bad, good, bad. And he wanted to make a point that is because he deals with all cities. But of course, I want the house to be neat. I don't want to be the deck of the Osmo until Wednesday, until next Friday, to be over there with and nobody needs all kind of insects inside the house. Of course, we're talking about it, but. The idea is that the proportion, what is the bottom line? The bottom line, you have to live together, you have to find a way to live together. This basically the bottom line is. So, and why it's so important to learn before Hanukkah? We learn Masechet Pesachim with you together. And tell me, the Mashiach is going to come with Hashem. Let's say he comes tonight. Okay? Forest Hills? Naniach.
Why not?
No, you come from a different region. So he comes from Forest Hills, and tomorrow we go to Beit HaMikdash. There is a coin over here, it's going to be in charge with Hashem. But he has to go to the procedure of getting pure. They have to take the water, the red cow, they have to slaughter, they have to make it 3 days and 7 days. You remember the whole thing that we learned?
Yeah.
So are we going to wait for the Kohanim and Levim to get pure?
No.
What is the halacha?
Halacha said that, you know, the Tzibur.
And the Tzibur, Tzibur, nachon? So when the Maccabim came to Beit HaMikdash, and the majority, and they were not pure for 3 years, there was nothing over there. So they allowed to go inside and start to function. What they were looking for?
For oil.
For oil, that the goyim did, that they was not contaminated.
Right.
Would they have to do it?
No.
No. And what Hashem is doing for them? A miracle for 8 days until a new shipment will come.
Okay.
But you know this is a miracle. You can take any kind of olive oil.
No. What was the problem? Because they're contaminating the Jewish nation.
The point.
So the fighting against it would be this.
Oh, this is Hanukkah.
Ken.
This is marriage life. The point that the SRA wants to do in America to us is contaminate our marriage life. He doesn't say don't get married. You're going to make a nice dish, he's going to give a nice flower, nice dish, everything, but they don't, but they're threatening the togetherness with all kinds of reasons. Everybody's right. And this is a threat. Because like the first night it used to do in the time of this Yehudit, and she was, and she said, what do you want from me? I don't know, you don't know me. No, I want to contaminate. I want to take the inside point and make it like not important. Therefore, I believe we learn from Leah today, what is the meaning of to be a good mother or a good Jewish person? Because all her goal is one thing, I'm going to build Am Israel, and then we're going to continue for the next thing. So therefore, we need, as you say, the positive in marriage life. We need all this, the children when they go in a healthy environment and everything. Your house has to be as holy as the, if you go to pray in the Beit HaMidrash, or in the Yeshiva, or in the synagogue. This is a house of good duty, not to fight, not to argue.
But how to do it? Can you teach us how to do this?
Just don't fight, what's the big deal? Even if you have to say, because don't look for right and wrong, don't be a judge, don't be a Supreme Court. There was election, there were all kinds of judges, but you're not in the list of the judges in Queens or in the United States. And don't make it, because you are in charge of Am Israel. So if your wife drives you crazy, say Baruch Hashem, pray to Gan Eden. If your husband drives you crazy, Baruch Hashem, kaparat avonot. But don't take it like he hurt me, I'm hurt, don't talk to me, I talk to you, because this is America. You have to be upset, you have to, the internal point, inside the point, this is the purity of the kedusha, that my wife, she's the other half of me. That thanks to her, I'm able to build Am Israel. And my husband is a part of me that we are building together. This is why I would like to come to this point. This is what we call love. This is a real love. You can't make it for the wedding, because the wedding is you don't get there. But you really to walk together.
How did Yaakov do it?
Huh?
How did Yaakov do it?
With a lot of love and compassion.
But you see, those people that you talk about right now, in their time, probably they were thinking, before the husband comes in, what to cook food from. In our time, most women are thinking how to start the fight from what the... Oh, yesterday you said to my father like this, my mother was like that, and this and that.
Now the question is, if let's say the husband, or let's say there is, I had a case where the husband was very, how do you say in Bukhara, in Egypt, used to come home, look for reasons to make fight. Why it's not ready, why it is, and you can find, if you're looking for a reason, you're going to find. Or sometimes the wife is looking for this. The other side should not be provoked. You have to remember a very important Bukharian idiom, the saying. For nice argument, you need two people. So, by the way, you cannot fight with this wall, because it doesn't answer you. This is the way, but you have to know that it's part of our Yetzirah, of our evil side, is to create this problem.
Yeah, but usually when people fight, the reasoning for that is everybody wants to be right. instead of trying to be smart.
No, he wants to be right. He thinks that he's right.
Yeah, but that's the whole point here. So what's the point of fighting then?
So don't be right. Be smart.
That's the point. Be smart. So one person has to shut...
But the question is all the time, the question is different. The question who is to be smarter? Both of them. Who has to be, who is smarter?
Both of them are smarter.
Who is smarter to stop it?
If you see, these fights are also like a cancer sickness. Certain cancer makes people ill, but eventually it heals a person. Certain cancer kills a person. If you know how to read between lines, certain woman or man, vice versa, they do things that if you see where it's going, if you don't stop it, then it's a problem. It's a big problem.
I'm not going to. You are very. You're like a surgeon, cancer. I'm going to a difference. I think it's just a matter of. It's like an infection, but it's not a cancer, because shalom can really solve a lot of things, peace, and be able to, not to make a point all the time. Don't be right all the time. Don't be a judge.
But that's not the whole point. Being right, people living under the pressure of society. I'll give you a small example. Yeah. If you take a guy, let's say that he decided to become religious.
Okay.
All of a sudden, he doesn't. 2-3 months, he comes to some shul. Let's say his rabbi lives in Mansi. For example, that's it. He decided to change his lifestyle, which is, according to you, I think is normal. He was living not a Jewish lifestyle, not becoming... Right away, his... let's forget about his side. His wife's side comes in. Yeah. Now, he says that, you know, from his mindset, he doesn't want to go there because that's not what he thinks. So right away, you have a pressure from a woman's side. Here comes the fight. Wife comes in. So, yeah, well, you're not going to my in-laws, you sure? And the guy now lost, and he has to do things against his own will. He doesn't want to do it. But because of the wife said go, now let's say he's going on a way back. You didn't go, or you decided not to, and another problem. So, what happens is, at home, you don't have a problem because of a wife or a husband. You have a problem because you have a problem from outside, and outside creates a problem in your home. That's the problem.
I think this person who become religious, according to you, is missing one ingredient. He doesn't have a rabbi to guide him. He has to text the rabbi, "Rabbi, should I go?" He says yes or no. Because sometimes we need to go to a certain break. Sometimes it's too dangerous, and it's a whole very sophisticated thing. These usually mistakes are happening when he wants to know from day number one, he wants to be the...
3 months he's going to a rabbi, and somebody's doing a wedding, mixed wedding. Would you let him go if he's rabbi?
It depends. I tell you a story. Once one of my students became religious, his brother made a wedding, and he wanted to go, and I told him to go for the chuppah. He went to the chuppah, and he was very upset. After 5 years, his other son made a wedding. He told me, "Rabbi, can I not go there?" I told him, "You have to go to the chuppah." I say, "No, I don't feel good," but it takes time. But and the rabbi will decide if he's ready or not ready, because if he's not ready and he's going to do something against his will, he's going to backfire. Mm-hmm. But you have to be very careful about it, and there is no easy answer, and there is no right answer, no wrong answer. There is the eyes of the rabbi who is leading you. Yes or no?
But that's not the point. The point is, it's not what he's going to do. The point is what his wife is going to do.
His wife has to call the rabbi too, and the rabbi is safe.
And what happens if she disagrees with this rabbi?
Huh?
If she disagrees with this
rabbi.
So you have a problem right here?
No.
Why not?
Find another rabbi.
Come, I'll show you so many people having the same problem.
I'll give you a list of very good rabbis in our community. You can go and you can choose, but you have to choose a person who both of you can listen, because it cannot go on one-sided. Because it's, when people feel under pressure, they defend themselves. But this is a...
People are always, balanced only when it comes to money. When it comes to everything else, people are this way, that way. Yeah. I want to get $100,000 from someone and say, you know what, I'll give you 50 in return. When it comes to money, he wants 100% back. Why? Because I gave you 100. Regardless of if it's interest or not. But when it comes to other stuff, people do a Chinese food menu. I want to do this. I don't want to do that. Like I have a person tomorrow
morning.
Ben.
Let's conclude. This never ends. It's like the...
I know.
The bottom line is like this. If your life is a mission, you can live happily. If it's not, if it's just a matter of lets another day to go by, it might be a big thing.
A person gets an apartment tomorrow, makes a big party. Ah, what happened? I have to do mezuzah. And no, because according to Jewish law, I said there's a lot of things according to Jew you have to do. But that's the only thing you choose. Why? Because you figure the Torah for you is a menu. It's like a restaurant, this type of sauce.
Don't be judgmental. Don't be judgmental. He wants to do the thanks for
But you don't get it. It's not judgmental. It's when it comes to their own interest,
But this human behavior, I will not change humankind because I change myself.
But this is what causes a problem, is because people are lost.
Of course, you're right. But is the way to fight with this is by anger, by make a point to him? No. Try to be nice to him. ברוך אדוני לעולם. רבי חייב בן הקשה אומר הצעה כזאת.